Would you let a convicted criminal stay in your home if you could help them turn their life around? Well, a groundbreaking new documentary series called Life on the Outside follows what happens when four Aussie households do just that. Have a look.
Hi, I'm Jeremy. Pleased to meet you.
Oh, it's beautiful. I love it.
I'll give you your key for you to come and go as you please.
Cool. Thank you very much.
It's good to finally actually have a proper toothbrush.
She's just let me into her house. Like, what the hell?
It's a bold experiment and the stakes are high.
But will it work?
That's the million-dollar question.
They've probably stolen from nearly every one of these shops along here.
It only takes one slip-up for things to go awry.
I'd be lying if I said I didn't feel like going to get some drugs.
He is in our house when we all go to bed, and I just have to trust that that's going to be OK.
If he became aggressive, my first responsibility is going to be to protect my partner.
I don't know how much more of this I can take.
Now, she was the star of prison drama Wentworth, and she presents this incredible series. Danielle Cormack joins us now. Danielle, this is awesome. Most people obviously would be pretty nervous, I guess, about inviting someone into their home. Can you tell us about the series and the people who took part in it?
Yeah, and understandably so.
Yeah.
So the series follows four people who have just been recently freed from incarceration. We have Sierra and Jeremy and Dane and Brett. And they are invited into family homes and also individuals' homes to give them a safe bed, some stability and security, to give them a second chance, really, and to help them re-establish themselves back into the community and to, I guess, you know, give them a better start than what usually happens when they don't have that, when you're not afforded that.
Yeah, when you don't have that stability in those first few months in particular, you've got nowhere to go, no one looking after you. It's tricky, right?
It is. Yeah, it is. And because most people find that they re-offend within that first 100 days. So this initiative follows 100 days to see what happens.
Yeah. Talk to us about the people who opened up their homes, because it would take a pretty special sort of person to do this. What made them want to do it?
Well, I think, you know, first and foremost, what struck me most about the families and the people that had put themselves forward, and there was quite a few people that actually that opened up their homes to begin with. Obviously, that was quite a selective, process. But I think most of them, they truly, I think, you know, they're where they position themselves in terms of kindness and giving people a second chance and also compassion seemed to be very prevalent to me. That it wasn't about, monitoring someone else. It was, their idea of equality and really giving people the opportunity to start their lives again and to really find their way and be proactive in their recovery and also to be pro-social as opposed to antisocial.
Was it more than just a room that these families were offering? Was it also a family?
Yeah, family. Yeah. Just, and once again, that stability, communication, acknowledgement. You know, for me, it's no secret that most human beings, you know, they want to be acknowledged, they want to be heard, they want a chance. Yeah. And especially if it's been, you've had a rough beginning to life, and a lot of people that I've met that have been incarcerated or part of the criminal justice system, they've had a very, very difficult time.
Because you've done incredible work behind the scenes in terms of that, haven't you?
Well, I'm drawn to to people that perhaps just need to have that kind of support, and whether it be here or internationally, and especially youth. Because, I think that, if you any child that has great support around them, whether it be their parents or caregivers or schooling, they're going to have a better chance at life and thriving rather than just surviving.
Yeah.
And, a lot of people that were part of this show, they didn't have that opportunity. And I feel very blessed that I have had that.
Yeah, I'm really excited about watching this because we live in a redemptive society. But there's only so far that people feel as though they're being redemption, What difference do you think this is going to make to people in general?
Well, I'd hope that it would provoke people to ask those questions about their own levels of understanding and forgiveness. Would they open up their own homes? What is our system set up like at the moment? Is it set up to help people survive when they come out of a system, or is it setting them up to fail? And I think, you know, for me, it's important to not just look at what we can do emotionally and psychologically to support each other as a community, but then start lobbying our politicians. What is the business of prison? It's a huge industry, and so if it's in within the system's interest to keep people incarcerated, that's not good for the taxpayers' money. Mm. So I'd also say to people, you know, put aside the emotion and the psychology of it. Look at where your money's being spent, and $110,000 per inmate per year, you know, just insane. To keep them inside, not a good thing. I'd prefer my money to be spent, and that's rehabilitating, that's creating courses and upskilling people so they don't reoffend.
And how must it be for the people who have been rehabilitated to move into these families? It must be just equally as nerve-wracking for those.
Oh, absolutely. It's a two-way street. That we're all human beings. Yeah. You know, some have had a better chance than others. And you know, and as the show will depict, you know, it doesn't work for everyone. This isn't a one-size-fits-all solution. This is just offering an initiative that might actually help, you know, shine light on where there's a deficit in the system, mm. and something that we can do that might actually be a little bit more progressive, less draconian. It's so archaic, some of these views of shunt people in prison because they've done bad.
Yeah.
And you know, taking into consideration the types of crimes as well. There's a lot of non-violent crime, a lot of people being punished for that.
Yeah.
You know, look at our drug reform and stuff like that. And that's what I'm hoping this show will highlight that. And I'm willing to be challenged by anyone that's like, oh, I think that people that are bad should be, you know, put away. And I go, okay, fair enough. You're allowed to have your opinion. Let's keep questioning that. You know, but thankfully to ITV and SBS, they've actually created a show that people can watch, and hopefully they'll ask themselves those questions. Would I support someone who needs their support?
Do you think it could be more than a show one day here in Australia?
I hope so.
Yeah.
And this is it. You know, I'm willing to agitate and put the conversation out there just to, you know, help challenge policy, help challenge reform, help challenge the system, and say, you know, is this right? Especially with the levels of Indigenous incarceration in this country.
Yeah.
Shocking.
Yeah.
Not cool.
Something's got to change.
Stamping feet.
Yeah.
I love it. That's why we know that you're the face and the star of Wentworth as well, and you also do so much behind the scenes
so
for prisoner rights. I know, but still, it's interesting that you've got that... that kind of insight into it as well that you're bringing to this documentary?
Yeah, and I think, you know, there was a logical relationship there. You know, people are going to go, oh, she was in a prison show, OK, well, let's listen to her. I don't purport myself to be any great voice of this, but I do believe that everyone deserves a chance. And you know, especially when you hear stories, so many stories, time and time again, of people, kids especially, who have been part of a system. It might not be incarceration, but, you know, part of child welfare and so forth, that have had a really challenging start. Yeah. So what can we do as a community? I see us all as being able to support each other.
Yeah. And sometimes it's just one person believing in you 100%. Can to completely alter the direction of your life.
Yes.
And you may not feel like a great voice in it, but you've certainly started the conversation, and that's what's so important about it.
Yeah.
Life on the Outside premieres tomorrow night at 8:30 p.m. on SBS. Danielle, thanks so much for joining us.
Congratulations.
I'm really excited
Thank
about
you.
This. It's awesome.
Thank you.